Hi guys, so today's video is going to be a little bit of a conversation, discussion about popular books and not the books themselves, but how we as a community sometimes put a lot of weight on those books and kind of our reaction to people who talk about them a lot. Before jumping into that though, really quick, I just want to kind of let you all know about this little, there's a little baby who I don't know personally, but I have seen this family trying to raise money for this baby, and I thought, well, heck, if I can make people aware of this situation, maybe I can help this family out. But their baby has something that they need treatment for, and this treatment is life-saving, but it's extremely expensive, and it's only available here in America, and if they don't get this treatment, they're probably gonna lose their child, and I just feel like nobody should have to think about losing their child because they can't afford to get the treatment for them. So anyway, I'm gonna have a link to this, what is going on with this child. I'll have it linked in the description bar down below, as well as where you can donate. Jumping into this topic though, I think that the pros of popular books, and I think it's pretty self-explanatory, is you get the chance to participate in something that involves other people. When books are popular, it's because a lot of people are talking about them. Jumping on the hype train can be loads of fun. I think it's really exciting when a lot of people are really pumped about something and you all get to kind of experience it together, especially because so many people who love to read don't necessarily have other people in their lives that they can talk to about reading. And so when you have popular books, and with the fact that social media is so big, you get to express not only your opinions, but you get to see other people's opinions, and you can have fun, silly, trivial arguments, or you can talk fan theories, all that kind of stuff. It's so fun. It's such a great way to enjoy something with other people. How that relates to BookTube, of course, is that if somebody is making videos and they are choosing to primarily stick to popular books, that means they're gonna get more views. And a lot of times more views means more people to talk to. It also can mean potential opportunities, it can mean exposure, it can mean money. There's a lot of really good things that can come of discussing popular books. There are definitely people who make their entire channels dedicated to reading popular books, a lot of times to books that they're not really wanting to read, that they're pretty sure they're gonna hate, because of the entertainment factor that they're providing other people. I know that's a thing where some people are upset when people only read things that they're probably gonna hate, and then sometimes that can feel like you're then going into a book looking for things to hate so that you can make a big joke of it, and then it's like, oh, but like that's really mean to the authors and stuff like that. I understand that side of that as well, but I also think for some people, you know, I try not to be judgy. I think when people do that, when they make videos like that, they're still providing tons of entertainment to a lot of people, and you know what? Sometimes life is tricky. That last point though is kind of also a con, because while I appreciate the humor and the entertainment that comes with people who have just these hilarious personalities and can do that, and by the way, I'm not speaking of anyone specifically, so if anybody's like, oh, you're throwing shade, no, but I just mean, I also am like tender-hearted sometimes, and I do think about like, oh man, that author, that sucks for them, and I feel bad about that element of it. So it is a little bit of a con when it comes to, you know, uplifting authors, but at the same time, often when books are getting this kind of recognition, they're already popular books anyway, so the author already has a big fan base. They're probably gonna have other opportunities to have future books published because publishers have seen, well, your book sells. All of that aside, I kind of want to transition into things that I personally do think sometimes can be a little bit of an issue with the way that we treat popular books or the way we treat people who talk about popular books. So one specific thing is the way that we give so much authority to people who speak a lot about popular books. I mentioned how a lot of times if you're going to talk about popular books, that is going to mean probably more views because people are interested in popular books and seeing people's opinions on them. And if you're getting more views, you're eventually going to be getting more money, you're going to be getting sponsorship deals, you're going to be getting opportunities. We sometimes have this, I don't think it's intentional, but I have seen it happen quite a lot, where if one person has gained a bigger following, for some reason, we start to treat their opinions as if their opinions are more accurate, or their opinions, like they're the authority on whatever topic we're discussing. So if we're talking about books, then it's like, if I were to express my opinion about a book, then if somebody else has a bigger following and they have also talked about that book, then you might see people leaving comments about like, well, so-and-so said, and like, well, it's all opinions. I don't know how often other people are noticing this, but I have noticed very often that when people's platforms become bigger, it's as if we think that their platform became big because they have more authority on a subject, when a lot of people on BookTube are on BookTube because they read books. So a lot of us are just expressing our opinions, and we're expressing something that is subjective. Opinions are not facts. In multiple different genres, you're gonna find different trends, and these trends are gonna play a role in what is considered popular. For example, in young adult fantasy, I enjoy fantasy. I enjoy both young adult and adult. And in young adult, it is dominated by the ladies. The characters, the authors, not all the time, but often the authors are white, they're straight, and so forth. I know it makes people uncomfortable to hear those words, but whatever, that's just, it's a fact. There are a lot of white women writing female characters in young adult. And then in adult, you have a lot of men writing, and then you have a lot of men who are the protagonists, and a lot of those men who are writing those books are white and straight. I see all the time people say that if you don't read a Song of Ice and Fire, if you don't read Lord of the Rings, if you don't read, you know, XYZ, these really popular books, then you don't have a place to talk about fantasy. Your opinions aren't as valid. I see it like it's a prereq. If you're gonna talk about other books, you gotta talk about these ones first. This is at least something I've experienced. I've had people tell me when I'm like, oh, I haven't read XYZ, and they're like, well, it's really a shame. If you're gonna have opinions about fantasy, you really need to read those books. So you have people pushing that viewpoint. If you feel that way, you feel that way. I disagree. You're allowed to feel that way. That's fine. But if you're pushing this, and then if we're also really giving our views, and then therefore unintentionally, but just this a product of YouTube, your money to people talking about specifically popular books, this particular trend, you're gonna find that the voices that are continuing to be heard the most are, in this particular instance, the white straight men. And if you go over to young adults, the ladies. The ladies are dominating that area. It's really difficult for dudes to break in and then have a standout in that area, because if I'm a girl and I'm like, oh, that book sounds interesting, and I see other people talking about it and I want to pick it up, I'm a female talking about a book written by a female with a female protagonist. And I know we all aim to not care about those things, but sometimes if we look at the publishing industry, where the money goes is where they're going to continue to put money into. I actually was very curious to look up when Lord of the Rings was published, because that is one of those prereqs that a lot of people insist you have to read in order to have any valid opinions about fantasy. I looked up when it was published, and it was published very close to the time where Rosa Parks did not want to give up her seat. There's a reason the foundation is the way it is, because of where the world was when that foundation for this particular genre was really coming to life as we know it today. Not Tolkien's fault, of course, and not any particular author's fault that that's how it is. It's also not readers' fault either. If somebody wants to read these older books, these popular books, that's okay. I'm not saying anybody is obligated to just throw those out the window and burn them because we need to forget those old white guys. But it does touch on some of my own personal decisions that I'm going to be making moving forward. So for example, I do want to be more aware of what I'm picking up. I've never felt inclined to pick up something, to only pick up popular books for the views. I don't really care. When I decide that the money I make from my videos is what determines what videos I'm gonna make and what books I'm gonna read, I don't wanna be making videos anymore. I wanna read what I wanna read. I, of course, am influenced by what I see other people talking about or what I see all of you recommending. If I see something and it's gaining some hype and it sounds good, I'm gonna pick it up. I'm interested. I'm on board. That said, there are so many books out there that I know are amazing little hidden gems. And many of those books do not get the recognition because of this vicious cycle of the people that get the most views and money are the ones talking about books that are more popular. Not always. There are exceptions, of course. I just also am really starting to see there's a lot of really, I mean, everybody is aware of this, but I just think it's even more obvious to me now the way that, you know, you can kind of get into this, you know, I have to read what's popular. I have to read what everybody's talking about, instead of the old fashioned, just go to a bookstore, go to the library, look around, what looks good, read the synopsis. Okay, this sounds good. I'm going to get it. That's weirdly foreign to us now because so many of us get our recommendations from BookTube. And so for myself, I really want to do a better job of, when people hear the word diversity or diversify, they immediately sometimes think it means like anti-what? And that's not what I'm saying. I just mean, I do read a very specific group of books and I really want to branch out and read other things. Because a lot of times when I pick up books that are outside fantasy or maybe books that are outside the norm, even within fantasy for me, I'm like, wow, that was really good. And then I get really excited. And then I'm like, guys, read this book. It was amazing. And then, you know, that video is going to get so many fewer views than if I'm like, popular series that I haven't read. And then that's going to get tons. I'm still going to pick up what I want to pick up. Some of what I want to pick up is going to be popular. But also, I am going to be asking you guys soon of some recommendations, or I'm kind of going to be doing a you choose my TBR. I'm going to make some categories. I haven't decided quite yet what those categories are going to be. I don't like talking about this because it sounds kind of conceited, I guess, but I know that there are people who, when they watch BookTube videos, mine included, that when they turn the video on, especially if it's a recommendations video or a wrap-up, they'll have their Goodreads open and then they'll click want to read for every single book that I talk about or a lot of the books I talk about. And just as somebody who can potentially kind of influence, I nobody likes the word influence or influencer, but as somebody who has the time to talk about books and to read books and then relay that information on to other people who maybe don't have as much time, if you're trusting my opinions or if you're coming to me for recommendations, that sort of thing, I want to make sure that I am more aware of what I'm reading and acknowledging these cycles that we find with popular books. Again, I'm going to read what I want to read. I'm not going to pick up something if I'm like, wow, that doesn't sound like my thing at all. But I think this will be a way for me to actually discover other books that I'm going to love and just fall head over heels for. And hopefully, in turn, a lot of you will also. But anyway, thanks so much for watching. I hope you have a great rest of your day. I will again leave the link to donate to that little baby down below. Have a great rest of your day, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.